Hello everyone, welcome back to AeroHub and welcome to the series of lectures in aerospace structures. In the previous lecture we discussed about different failure modes of rivet and also we have seen the relationship between diameter of the rivet as well as the thickness of the plate. And in this lecture we will see how to estimate the efficiency of a riveted joint. And it's already defined here, the efficiency of a riveted joint is ratio of strength of the joint to the strength of solid plate, and the strength of solid plate will be almost equal. It's like we have a constant, that is the strength of solid plate, and the strength of solid plate is given by P into T into sigma T, where P is the pitch, T is the thickness of the plate, and sigma T is nothing but the safe tensile stress of the plate. Okay, it is given here, P is the pitch, T is the thickness, and sigma T is the safe tensile stress. Now, the efficiency of the joint is nothing but the strength of the joint. So, the strength of joint is nothing but, we estimated in the last lecture, the resistance to tearing failure, resistance to shear failure, as well as resistance to crushing or bearing failure. Okay, we estimated that types of failure. We studied about the types of failure in the last lecture, and we estimated the resistance to the failure, this particular failure. Like I have a formula for tearing strength, and I have a formula for shear strength. Also, I have a formula for the crushing strength. Okay, so to find out the efficiency of a joint, it is nothing but least of PT is nothing but the tearing strength. Okay, PS is nothing but the shearing strength, and PC is nothing but crushing strength or bearing strength. Okay, so tearing efficiency is nothing but eta T is nothing but PT by P into T into sigma T. We have the formula for tearing strength or tearing resistance as P minus D into T into sigma T, where P is the pitch, D is the diameter of the rivet, T is the thickness, and sigma T is the safe tensile stress, and it is divided by the strength of the solid plate. Okay, it is nothing but P into T sigma T, that is P T sigma T. So I can neglect T into sigma T from both numerator and denominator, so I will be getting P minus D by P, where P of numerator as well as denominator is nothing but the pitch of the plate. Okay, now similarly we have to obtain the shearing efficiency, that is eta S, that is nothing but shearing resistance divided by the strength of solid plate, and we have the formula, N is nothing but number of rivet per pitch length. Okay, small letter N, and N into pi by 4 D square into tau. Tau is nothing but the safe shear stress of the rivet. Okay, we have done this in the previous lecture, everything. I have explained how this formula also is coming. Pi by 4 into D square is the area of the rivet, and tau is the safe stress. Okay, divided by the strength of the solid plate, and this formula is applicable for single shear. If I want to apply this formula for double shear, I have to multiply the numerator by 2. Okay, and also in the design case, instead of 2 we are using 1.875 or 1.75. we discussed that also in the previous lecture. And last efficiency is crushing efficiency, that is eta C, that is PC, that's nothing but the crushing strength to the strength of the solid plate. Okay, it is equal to N is nothing but number of rivet per pitch length, D is the diameter, T is the thickness of plate, sigma C is the crushing stress, that is a safe crushing stress or safe bearing stress, divided by P into T sigma T. P into T, P is nothing but the pitch, T is the thickness, and sigma D is a safe tensile stress. Okay, so to estimate the efficiency of the joint, we will estimate these three efficiencies, and we will check out which is having the lowest efficiency, and that will be the efficiency of the joint. I'll repeat, the lowest of three efficiency, that is from equation 3, 4, 5, you will be getting a certain value, which is the lowest value, and that will be the efficiency of the particular riveted joint of our concern. okay. So this is a very small lecture, is nothing but it is mainly applicable in numerical problems, and we will try to solve from numerical from the next lecture onwards. And mostly we will be winding up our aerospace structures class by 6 to 7 lectures. Okay, so thank you for listening. Take care.